were finally reunited with our trail family after being separated for weeks. That night, we celebrated new friends and had a dance party in the shelter the best way we knew how. We crossed out of Pennsylvania and hoped all her rocky roads were behind us. In the middle of the woods that day, there was a cooler chained to a tree with cold soda and snacks. I never did get tired of watching the deer. We hit another fire tower right at sunset, so we climbed to the top before setting up camp. The next morning, we wandered a mile off trail to a restaurant by a lake. By this point, we had been walking on the trail for over 3 months, and it had lost a bit of its magic. We needed a change of pace, so I suggested a 30-mile yellow blaze through New Jersey. Our new friends were extremely against yellow blazing, so they stayed on trail, and we wandered off. That night, we slept in an open field beside the road, with a couple bottles of wine to keep us company. I think the road walk was exactly the change that we needed. By this point, we were about 20 miles off trail, so people weren't as familiar with thru-hikers. Several people stopped to ask us what we were doing and offered us beer or snacks. We even got pulled over by the cops. One evening, we walked past a fancy house with a man mowing the lawn in the front yard. He asked us what the hell we were doing and then invited us to have a beer in his backyard. His wife wrapped up Moss's ankle, which had swelled up from road walking. They made us burgers, and then he drove us into town to a liquor store.
First time. We've forgotten to toast you before.
After we had so much fun on our road walk, we didn't really want to get back on trail. We decided to opt for walking the train tracks this time. Once again, we were about 20 miles off trail, so people weren't too familiar with thru-hikers. We stopped by a breakfast spot, and they kind of assumed we were homeless, so they gave us a bag of free bagels. Toasty was extremely excited. He spent all afternoon looking for the perfect bagel stick. Now that Moss had a nice ankle wrap, I figured he could handle a little extra weight. We crossed back over the trail and grabbed a hitch to the Warwick Drive-In Theater, an extremely popular campsite with thru-hikers. While we were in Warwick, Sock Monkey, Moss, and I all decided to get tattoos. The rest of our friends were a half day behind us, so we spent our free time entertaining ourselves the way any broke hobos would. hopped back on trail for a few days and set up a rendezvous point for Moss's parents to come pick us up. One of the bridges that the AT crosses over was closed due to instability, but we walked right past it and found Miss Janet, who was giving out ice cream for trail magic. After hanging around for a while, we realized that there was no way for Moss's parents to meet us at the rendezvous point with the bridge closed, so we had to backtrack 5 miles, and we got in trouble for walking across it this time. Then, via Moss's request, we headed straight to the roller skating rink without even showering. That night, we celebrated a hot shower and a soft bed, and some of us celebrated a little too hard. That day, we nursed our hangovers and then promptly went to a brewery where we drank leftover beer from the table next to us. Moss's parents were not entirely thrilled with the hobo life.
What if they find out they have COVID? You never know. Pretty soon, we hit the Trailside Museum and Zoo, a section of trail that runs directly through a zoo. There are white blazes along the path and everything. Soon, the trail would be crossing over Bear Mountain, which had a train station that ran directly to New York City. We originally planned to camp in New York City, but my aunt surprised us with a reservation for a hotel room. We grabbed an Airbnb in Bear Mountain so that we could grab train tickets in the morning. Suddenly, we had stepped foot in a completely different world. It was overwhelming and crazy. Even though we had showered the night before, we knew that we stunk. Finally, after an hour of going back and forth with the hotel desk, who didn't want to let a bunch of stinky hikers in, we had our room.
Nah, okay, that was cool enough. 70% win.
while we were there, I absolutely did not swim in the fountain at Central Park. That would be illegal. We spent most of our time in Chinatown, gorging ourselves on food. And Popeye joined the tattoo gang. We didn't just come to New York for fun, though. A few weeks back, Sock Monkey had told me he was ready to get off trail. Hiking the Appalachian Trail was my dream, and he had just come along because I'd asked him to. I bought him a plane ticket home, and we said our goodbyes. I had plans to leave early in the morning and catch the first train back to Bear Mountain. I was ready to get out of New York, but our tramley wanted to stay a bit longer. In the morning, it was just Moss who hopped on the train with me. These were weird days for me, and like most hikers, I was exhausted from the trail. Moss and I agreed to walk the railroad tracks as far as they would take us. We spent our days swimming in creeks to cool down and walking the tracks in the hot sun. Miles were done now, and we had had some absolutely incredible memories with our trail family. Now, it was just us.